did you do that?
Not trust her.
Because she's a god?
Have I taught you nothing, boy?
But she's helped us a lot.
She lied.
Some people value their privacy. Best not to judge, brother.
When I require your council head, I will ask.
Fair enough. Get me to Tyr's temple in the Lake of the Nine, and I'll get you to Jotunheim as promised.
We know the temple. What's there?
Only the last living giant in Midgard. Who better to tell us the way?
The World Serpent? Wait, do you know how to talk to him?
Indeed. He speaks an obscure tongue more ancient even than these mountains. None are left in Midgard who speak it. Except, of course, for me.
You do?
That's true. You wouldn't know it to look at him, but Jormungandr is a sparkling conversationalist.
This'll be fun. Almost there! I can't jump over with those wooden boards in the way.
Chest. I've got something good inside. I do too. It's probably in some dumb place that I probably have seen.
Atreus, here.
Yes, Father.
I know I'm holding up the mission, but it'll be worth it. Where could it be, man? It's just an R. It's just quite literally the R. I'm gonna find it, and I'm gonna be like, what the fuck? I always do this to myself. If I remember correctly, it might be on the house.
Thank you.
my big boy brain. There has to be something.
Hey, come look at this.
Look at what? Time to use the internet. Where am I? The witch's house. this shit. Alright.
Atreus, follow me.
Sorry, I got distracted.
So, Mimir, why did Freya spin your face?
No. Speak of Baldur. He claims nothing harms him.
Aye. Baldur is blessed with invulnerability to all threats, physical or magical.
The boasting of a god. Everyone has a weakness.
Not him, I'm afraid. Baldur is blessed with invulnerability to all threats, physical or magical.
You just said that, Mimir.
Did I?
What is the source of this power?
Well, as I recall, it involved, spell?
Mimir?
Parts of my brain must still be coming back to life. Just need a moment to finish waking up.
Hope he's not broken. Mimir, we're in the lake.
Perfect. Dock us near the bridge.
Something over here. Right, let's go around, okay. Let's go in again.
Ed, how do we speak to the serpent?
There's a horn on a platform at the middle point of the bridge. Take me to it.
Finally, that horn!
Come on, son.
Good. Now put my lips to the horn. That statue made in honor of Thor. And seeing as the world serpent absolutely abhors the fat dauber, he was probably sick of looking at it.
But doesn't that hurt?
Well, he and Thor have a bit of an unpleasant history between them. Or they will, anyway. So I guess waking up to see it was worse than the thought of lumps of solid stone passing through his gullet. You want me to ask him?
No. Our only concern is Jotunheim.
All right, wish me luck. I've still got it, lads. He remembers me. Why you? Help you. ensure we're heading in the right direction.
Listen closely now. We need two things to get us into the land of the giants. First, we need to learn the travel rune that opens realm travel to Jotunheim. Second, we need to carve that rune into the special gateway.
Is that one of the people we first met you?
Correct. Except the giants, in their infinite wisdom, saw to it that no ordinary chisel would do the job. Only the tip of a magical chisel opens that gate. Luckily, I know where it is. It's not far.
He looked kind of mad for a moment.
Now that, I thought I said you were friends of Odin. You'll forgive me. I've never spoken the ancient tongue sober.
Wait, look! The water's dropped even further. You can see more of the realm towers and statues. I even see new places to explore along the shore.
Where is this chisel?
Find me a boat, and we'll go from there.
Get to the boat. We can either look for that special chisel now, or go exploring for a little while. I'm happy with whatever you want to do. What's hiding behind this?
Which way to the chisel?
Boat under the bridge, keep rowing towards the statues of the oarsmen, then thread past between them.
Did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Well, she blames me in large measure for her present circumstances, and not totally without reason. It all goes back to the long war between the Aesir and Vanir. Prior to that, wars for the Aesir were easily won, but the Vanir had proved their equal and exacted devastating damage. Both sides suffered tremendous losses, and for many of us, quite frankly, war was simply no fun anymore. A rather senseless waste of precious life. Wouldn't you agree, brother? Precisely. Enough was enough. And at last, Odin's most brilliant advisor became determined to find a more enlightened path. He set about to broker a peace between the gods. It took some convincing, but ultimately Odin was persuaded to marry his deadliest enemy, a certain Vanir goddess, legendary not only for her fertile beauty, but her genius at the very Vanir magic that Odin had long aspired to master.
Freya married Odin? What was in it for her?
It was a sacrifice to protect her people. A selfless act of love. Truly, she deserves better than she got. But of course, there's more to that story.
I want to fight you.
Nightmares, huh? What awful pests!
I think I'm getting the hang of this.
I thought it was an enemy.
Just make sure you watch each other's backs in the storeroom. Wouldn't want to lose my loyal customers.
Huh. What is this place?
Could it be? The Eight Thrones.
Stop being coy, Head. Do you know this place or not?
I'm Mimir, the smartest man alive. I know many things.
Well, whatever this place is, it looks important.
To who? There is little of value here.
Poor Fafnir. There's a fine line between ambition and greed, you know.
Need to get this man some new boots.
I can't believe Odin and Freya were ever married.
Love and hate are more closely intertwined than you might imagine. For instance, Odin hates the giants and they him. But Thor's own mother was the giantess Björgun, one of Odin's great loves.
Enough. No stories. Not while on foot. Our focus is the road.
Completely understand.
You are taken from this realm too early.
You who walks among the living! My beloved Gulvig calls to me. She yearns for peace. Yet her remains lie in pieces. I beg of you, make my Gulvig whole again.
You want us to collect her bones? Gross.
Gulvig's Sather magic knows no bounds. She can reunite you with those you've lost.
Really? How?
Boy,
I can smell your grief, child. Rest assured, her magic is strong enough to create bridges between life and death, if only for a short while.
Boy, we are leaving.
They've taken three of Sweet Gulvig's bones and spread them across the lake. Bring your bones, child. Gulvig will reward you.
Good. The special chisel is ahead, past this gate.
Prepare yourself!
Ooh. That's for hands, buddy.
Thank you.
fair Gulven. This realm suffers without her spirit.
Father, maybe we should look for those bones.
Why?
Didn't you hear him? We could talk to Mom again. If we keep an eye out,
look
while
if you wish, boy. I will not be distracted by this fool's errand.
Later on,
this chisel we seek. What is it?
I'm glad you asked, actually. I have just the story for you. There was a giant once named Thamur. A very giant giant. Who, despite his mountainous size, was without question the greatest stonemason this world had ever seen. Proud Thamur hoped to one day pass his vast knowledge onto his son. But young Hrimthur had the heart of a warrior. Perhaps the father had too much fear in him, or the son too little. Either way, a quarrel of theirs spiraled out of control, and the overworked stonemason, bonk, struck his son. Hrimthur ran off into the night. Feeling shame and regret, Thamur chased after his son. But in his emotional state, soon found himself wandering Midgard, lost and alone. Sadly, he caught the eye of the one person he didn't want to meet alone that night, so far from home. Thor.
And? What happened next?
You'll see.
Thor killed him. No. He fell in the village?
Aye. When Thamur fell, he crushed a charming place famed for worshipping the Vanir god Njord. Thor always took credit for planning that one. The truth is, the sweaty clawbag just got lucky.
Enemies. Should we attack? A wolver!
A dangerous beast. We will take him down together.
Ready, Father!
Move on behind you, brother!
Yes, a very, very giant chisel.
Regular bird. I just killed a regular bird.
What happened to the survivors?
Oh, Thamur was a frost giant. When he died, his final breath froze everything.
All right. How long ago did this man die? It's like perfectly preserved. I know it's ice and shit.
Find the tip of that chisel.
Wait.
That's the magic we need.
Okay. Tip of that chisel. Alright. My question is. Oh wait, this is his hand. This is his hand. Okay.
Are we doing this? An all-fine light crystal. Wonder what it's for.
Here we go! Tell me when!
Throwing hands with you, buddy.
Over on your left, brother!
What does it say?
Sir. To Njord, we offer back the seas back.
Ah, yes. It was believed Njord calmed the winds and seas for the fishermen. For that, they loved and worshipped him here.
Follow me, Atreus.
Well, here's the base for the crystal we saw, but how do we get it down?
Alright, so we're gonna need some fucking sap. Some good old sap, right? Over there as well.
Hey,
How are we getting down there?
I have a plan.
You do?
Do not act so surprised.
Well, no offense, brother, but I don't even think Thor with Mjolnir in hand could get through that much ice.
Then Thor is a fool.
This should be entertaining.
Boy.
Wow, that was something, that fight. Here, catch. Well, that was a waste of a perfectly good hour.
How were you not seen? There is nowhere here to hide.
Oh, that. It's a little trick my people can pull. A special way of not being seen.
You can be invisible?
More like I can step into the realm between realms. And your mind doesn't understand what it's seeing, so it sees nothing at all. That's how we avoid ever having to actually use the weapons we craft. It doesn't seem to work on dragons, though.
Your brother wanted to know if you're getting enough to eat. I guess I could tell him you are.
Brock was asking about me?
on his breath. You let him touch this again. Come on, then.
So that's how Brock was in the temple right after the water. He stepped between realms.
Okay, now, shush. I need complete silence for this. There you go.
No idea what that does, but sure.
So, this plan of yours.
Can you guess it?
Knowing you, it doesn't involve standing around here.
Correct.
But how do we move forward? Boy, Farmer really liked jewelry, didn't he? Even braided his beard with it.
I happen to think you look dashing. For a snow-covered corpse.
Careful! My shop's right here!
Yeah, but we're going back because there was some shit we had to take care of. If you don't remember, my child. Sideways and like back one and then a fucking the rest of the elbows, the three backwards, okay. Shabby, not shabby. All right, now we go get our piece.
Atreya, here.
Yes, father.
Woo!
Thank you.
A formless substance found inside the realm's here, used to enhance unique properties in various talismans. Okay. It's used to like upgrade the ship. Have an idea. Alright, ladies and gents, this is where we're gonna leave it off.
So,
come back next time.
Can you guess it?
Knowing you, it doesn't involve standing around here.
Correct.
But how do we move forward?
You will see, my child. You will see.